Friends, in the previous classes, we saw the vowels and began the consonants. The consonants are 18 in number as we saw then, and we had dealt with ka, na, cha and nya. So we continue with the list. The next letter is ta. Ta. The vertical line from up to the lower portion and extended on the right. This is written like ta, and the pronunciation is ta as in tub, turn. The English letter L has a longer limb, a vertical limb. Here we find the limb above is smaller than the horizontal line. So, this is written this way, come down and proceed eastward. The next letter is na, with all the circles possible, the maximum is 3. Please watch, circle goes up, round it, go up, round it, extend, come down. It starts with a circle, takes a round, and another circle is added, and you end it with 2 lines, one horizontal and the other vertical. So, this is how it is written. It is a bit difficult. You have to practice it further and see that there are 3 circles, because you will be coming across another letter which has only 2. This is called na, a retroflex noun. Na. Bend your tongue, take it up, touch the alveolar and pronounce it, retroflex na. Now we saw ta and na. The next letter is ta. This is written this way, that is a vertical line going up, a horizontal line extending itself, another vertical line coming down, a curve you have, go up, bend it, again curve, come down, extend it and end it. That is, it goes up, horizontal, vertical, a bend, further extension, horizontal, and then it comes down. This is ta, as in thumb. And naturally it is followed by a nasal sound of this particular hard sound is na. It is written in 2 ways. Let us see the first one. The same way you did ta. Go up, extend, come down, make a curve, extend it, come down and bend it. Up, horizontal, vertical, curve, further extension and a bend. This is na. going down, we have another letter, that is pa. See how is written, a vertical line from above, top to bottom, extend it on the right, horizontal, go up vertically, come down, extend it, go up, very simple. Yeah, it is written this way, a vertical line comes from above, goes down, takes a curve, further goes up, and then you extend it, a horizontal line and another vertical. See how this is being written. Naturally, this sort of disconnection you find, and it can be there, it need not be there. Va, that is, start with a circle, as the above letter go up, come down, from here you take, you have to take a horizontal bend and then go up, round, go up, come down, horizontal line, a vertical line, this way. Va, as in vulgar or vulture. Do you remember this letter? I don't think you would have forgotten, because it was done only a few minutes before. This is ma. Extend it from the tip of the end, go down, slightly bend and curve it. See again, this way, horizontal, take a bend, come down and do like this. This is going to trouble you for some time because of the pronunciation. It is ra, ra. The approximate can be the first syllable of the French word Jean, the French word Jean. I am not sure whether I am right, but you have to find out whether it is similar to that. This sound we have only in two languages in India, one is Tamil and the other is Malayalam. And let me remind you that the word Tamil, remember we started with that, this word has this particular letter ra, ta, mi, r, and the last letter is na. See how this is being written. A small circle goes up, another circle goes up, comes down. Let me recall a few sentences with which we began these classes. Vowels are independent, can be pronounced independently. consonants are dependent on the vowels for pronunciation. That is, consonants cannot be pronounced by themselves. So, we have to add a vowel to make it pronounceable. This I made clear in the beginning. Now, we know these are the consonants, and naturally these should have been added with some vowel or other, otherwise I would not have been able to pronounce any of these letters. How to distinguish a consonant? The easiest method possible has been found out for that. That is to say, put a dot above and it becomes a consonant. I have been pronouncing it as ka, nga, cha, nya, ta, na, etc. Now that I have put the dot above, they are consonants and they cannot be pronounced without the help of a vowel. So, if I have to pronounce this separately, I have to say ik or im. I take the help of a vowel to begin with so that I can end the sound with this. So, the definition that a consonant cannot be pronounced independently is proved. For this, a vowel is added and it becomes ka. This is consonant ik. A vowel is added, that is a is added, ik plus a becomes ka. I called it ka in the beginning. Hope you remember. This is actually the consonant ik plus a. So, this becomes ka. So, also na, cha, nya, all the letters. So, these consonantal vowels alone make the language. They form into words and words form the language. Once you are thorough with these consonants, I hope you are, because you have to put only a dot above the letters which I have taught and then call it a consonant. Let me start with ka. You know that. What is this? Na. Now, I will read it as ka. Na, ka, na. I put a dot above. What is this now? Kan, kan means an eye. Kan, an eye. One more word. What is this? Pa. This is la. Pa, la. Pa, la, pa, la. Of course, this is a word and it has a meaning. I am not going to trouble you with that meaning now. I am concentrating upon the consonants. A consonant is a letter with a dot above. So, I put a dot above this and what is now? Pa and la with a dot l. Pa l. Pal. Pal is a tooth. one more word so that we can frame a couple of words meaning something different. I put a consonant here. When I mean a consonant, naturally it must have a dot above. What is this? A, N, A, N, N, N. It has a meaning. A word must have a meaning. A word is a combination of letters and sounds, but it must have a meaning to be called a word. So, N is my. You have come to know three different words with the available letters you have learned. I put this here. What is this? N. What does it mean? My. I take this up and put it before kan. N kan. Two words. N kan. N meaning my, kan meaning an eye. N kan my eye. Now you have started learning Tamil in all earnest. So also I join these two and that becomes un pal. Can you give me the meaning? Un means you are singular. Pal, a tooth. Un pal, your tooth. Now, this can be stretched. Every consonant needs a vowel to become a consonantal vowel. Now we have seen only pa being added to these consonants. So this is a and I make it o. So it plus a naturally will become ka. How to indicate it? So this a, the sound a, the vowel a in combination with the consonant must have a symbol so that consonant or vowel can be pronounced properly and rightly. So what is the symbol? This is the symbol for a. How is this written? A vertical line going from the bottom, stretching itself and coming down. This is the form. If you take the circular method, it will be easy to write. This is a symbol, remember, this is a symbol to denote a. That is, this is the symbol to denote the elongated a. So naturally I put this symbol here and it becomes ka. Ik plus a ka, and the symbol remains the same all through.